to figure this out through the court system, the Democrats had a different plan. And that plan was basically to take over the government by mob rule. Okay? They actually pay train tickets for people from Philadelphia to come up to Harrisburg and basically to intimidate the legislature. What they did was they stormed the legislative areas. At one point, Thaddeus Stevens was in the Senate, and he actually had to jump out a window to get away from this rampaging mob that was after him. That's the next photograph, which is an editorial cartoon, which shows him jumping out the window. This is Thaddeus Stevens over on this side, and you can see they have his wig here. He did not have any hair. From middle age on, he didn't have any hair. That hair you see on him was a wig. So here they have an editorial cartoon showing him losing his wig and his hat and such like that. So in any case, on December the 4th, the mob essentially took over the legislature. And the Democrats actually posted guards outside of the House and wouldn't let any of the people from the anti-Mason Whig House in. Now, at this point, Governor Rittner, who is still in power until the next governor came into power in January, actually tried to get help from the federal government, from the federal troops that were in Carlisle, to put down the mob. But the government at that time was headed by Martin Van Buren, a Democrat, who wasn't interested in helping out. And even trying to get the state militia involved was a real effort for him. And he finally got the state militia to come up to Harrisburg from Philadelphia, armed with buckshot, thus the name the Buckshot War. However, Rittner kind of sabotaged his own efforts because he told the troops not to invade the legislative compound. Instead, they just rimmed it. But the Democratic mob still had control of the legislature. The last say in this should have been that the state senate, which had to approve one or the other houses. And they first approved the Democrat, I mean the anti-Mason Whig House. But that didn't seem to change anything. And so finally, on December 25th, they approved the Democratic House, and they voted 17-16. Now this, to me, is the only time, I'm not aware of all different state histories, but I think this is one of the few times, if not the only time, that a state government has actually been taken over by force during our country's history, unless somebody else has heard differently. Okay, but in any case, so the Democratic House and Democratic governor, essentially the Tapeworm Railroad was dead. There were a lot of complaints about it. Because of the expense of the Tapeworm Railroad, and why it's called Tapeworm Railroad is because it squiggled along the mountains and kind of looked like a tapeworm. At least they said that way. In the end, the state spent $750,000 on the Tapeworm Railroad and then just abandoned it for about 50 years. During the time, however, it did have one significant, it played one significant role during the Battle of Gettysburg, July 1st, 1865, during the first day of the battle. Some of the Confederate troops, there was an unfinished railroad cut on the battle lines, and some Confederate troops tried to sneak past the Union forces along this railroad cut, but the Union troops discovered them and mowed them down in the unfinished railroad cut. However, by 1889, you don't have to go that far. You don't have to start yet. We'll just leave that for. By 1889, the Western Maryland, had taken over the route and did build a railroad. And the New York Times wrote an article about it, and the article ended. It said, in 1851, the legislature made the Hanover and Gettysburg Railroad Company a present to the franchise and property of the Old State Road. The company built a road from Hanover to Gettysburg and failed. The charter and assets subsequently passed into the ownership of the Western Maryland Railroad Company, and thus Thaddeus Stevens' old Tapeworm Railroad, that once so aroused the fear of Baltimore and Maryland, fell into the hands of a corporation owned by Baltimoreans and chartered by Maryland. The entire benefit of the $1 million thrown away on the old road by the state of Pennsylvania accrued to men who had no part or interest in the original project, but who had at least completed a plan which had it been successful half a century ago, would have changed the commercial and political history of the entire country.